Hi, it's Penny here. Welcome to another reading vlog. This week I've got a few different things that I'm reading. Firstly, I've got a bunch of graphic novels that I've been meaning to get to for several weeks, so I'm gonna finally prioritize them. I did start last night reading volume 11 of Giant Days, and then I also have 12, 13, and 14, which will finish the series off. This is just a series about a bunch of girls who are going to university and having all the typical university struggles. I just really enjoy it. It's a lot of fun, kind of silly, but also just really nostalgic for university times and enjoying that life. And I really love the main girls, and I'm gonna really miss them when I finish the series. Although I guess I can always reread it. As well, I have volume 10 of The Girl from the Other Side, which is this series all about this cute little girl being raised by this scary demon guy. Volume 10, quite a lot has happened. It's quite heartbreaking, but I am looking forward to continuing the series. And as well, I have Dark One by Brandon Sanderson. So this is a story about this guy who finds out that he's prophesied to be like this great evil in this alternate dimension. And so he kind of just decides to go with it, but also try to destroy the prophecy at the same time. I don't really know, but I like Brandon Sanderson, so I wanted to read it. So that's all my graphic novels. Hopefully I can get through all of those. The other book I want to read is The Liminal Space by Jacquie McRae. This is a Maori author. It's a book, I think, just about this small town and these people who feel like they don't really belong, and one of them is potentially really strange. Maybe they're all really strange. I'll be honest, this is just a beautiful book and I wanted it because it was beautiful, but it does also sound really interesting, so hopefully I can get to that as well. It's pretty short, so if I can get to it, hopefully I can finish it. As far as audiobooks go, I kind of want to read two this week, even though they're kind of both long and that seems unrealistic, but I'm planning to go for a lot of walks and play a lot of Pokemon Go in the next week, as well as going into the office a lot and commuting, so hopefully I can get through both of them. I'm gonna try. The first one I'm gonna read is The Fires of Vengeance by Evan Winter. That's the sequel to Rage of Dragons. So in this we have a boy named Tao who is trying to get revenge on the death of a family member, and as part of that he enters the army where his people are warring against these other people, and he kind of learns how to use these magical abilities, even though mostly it's the women who use the magic, and they have it's quite an interesting magic system. Part of it is that they're able to call dragons, but there's a lot more to it than just the dragons. There really isn't that much dragons in the series, despite the first book being called Rage of Dragons. Now, I'll be honest, in the first book I found Tao, the main character, kind of boring. I don't tend to like revenge plots, but Tao's girlfriend and also the queen were both very interesting characters, and I feel like there's hints we're going to get more of them in the second book, so I'm really hoping that we will. And as well, I want to read Red Seas Under Red Skies, which is the second book in the Lies of Lochlemora series, the Gentleman Bastards series. The first book is called The Lies of Lochlemora. I did really enjoy that, and actually, like, at the time I had a few criticisms of it, but I'll admit it's been a while since I read that first book, but when I thought about it I can pretty much remember everything that happened, which I think is quite a compliment, because my memory is terrible, so if I remember it, it must have been quite memorable and good. So I am looking forward to getting back into that as well, probably later in the week. Anyway, I've got lots of plans for reading and productivity and feeling healthy and happy, hopefully, this week, so I guess I will try and do those things. Good morning. So it turns out that I won't be working in the office today because this morning my car was completely dead. It doesn't do anything, pretty much. I'm gonna have to call the AA this afternoon and see if I can fix it, but I decided, too bad, I'm not going to the office. I went for a lovely walk instead of traveling into town. Much nicer. And while I was doing that, I did start listening to Fires of Vengeance, and there was a part with the dragon, which I liked. Also, I remembered that someone had died and I'd completely forgotten, so it kind of gave you a little recap, kind of, through the story, but of what had happened in the previous book, and I appreciated that because I had forgotten some things. But then it's kind of just this big guess you could call it like a war council. People, different factions kind of fighting against each other. I mean, it was more interesting than that kind of stuff can be, but it's also not really my favorite. It is written quite well, but I'm a bit worried this book is going to be all about the war, and books about wars tend to bore me. So we'll see how we go when I get to reading some more of that. As well, last night I did read a couple more volumes of Giant Days, and I have to say, this one, it made me cry. It was so sad. This is meant to be like my fun graphic novel series, but I mean, there was a lot of fun stuff in it, but some stuff happened to McRae. Look at this alternate cover. Oh, I can't show it to you. Look at it. You can just tell. It made me so sad. But I guess that goes to show how much I've come to care about the characters, that it made me that sad. And now I've only got this one left to read. So I'll try and read this today, since I'm not going into the office now. I can probably read it. Oh, I might go for a walk at lunchtime again. It's really nice weather at the moment, actually. Like, cold because it's winter, but sunny, so perfect almost. But at some point, I'll read this one. This one actually doesn't seem that long, so it probably won't take that long. I'm probably going to cry when I finish that series, to be honest, because I'm just going to miss those girls so much. I'm probably going to have to reread it in the future. Anyway, since I'm working from home, I guess I will do some work. I'm really annoyed about my car. I hope it's just like a flat battery and it can be fixed easily. I guess we'll see. Oh, we're getting to that point in my roots where it looks terrible. So this week it has been long and annoying and I didn't like it. Basically, I just had a million meetings at work at the same time as a whole bunch of drama was happening in one of my teams, and honestly, I don't want to do that. Usually I quite enjoy my job, but if it was like this last week all the time, I would definitely not. So hopefully next week will be better. I don't even know, did I tell you about the fact that I finished Giant Days? Maybe not. Anyway, I finished Giant Days and I just really loved it. I think it wrapped up pretty well. It did like an extra chapter after they finished university, which I thought made you feel better about the fact that it was ending. I think I kind of cried a little bit when they graduated at the end of this second to last chapter. And I think if that had been the end, I just would have been kind of heartbroken. But like, getting a little glimpse into the fact that they were going off to live the rest of their lives and they were still going to be friends and they were still going to help each other out. That was really satisfying, and I really enjoyed that series. I think I would read it again. So since then, I have also been listening to Fires of Vengeance. I think I'm about a third of the way through, although Audible makes it very hard to see how far through you are. And like, so far I'm not super engaged. I don't know if it's something about the way the audiobook narrator reads things in quite a calm voice, so even when Tao's like having emotional reactions over things and like big fights and outbursts, it's still very calm in the way that it's narrated, which doesn't quite match in my opinion. But as well, it's just like this war we're kind of leading up to, like trying to get this city back under the control of the queen, and it's been a lot of just talk about what we're gonna do about that but not actually really doing anything. It's also spending a lot of time on this romance that it's teasing between two characters that I don't really care about. That romance, you guys know, I don't really care that much about a lot of romances in general, but this one I really don't care about, and I don't care about the war. So I'm kind of worried that I'm not gonna like this book, not because it's not good, but just because it's not a story that's focusing on the things that interest me, which the things that interest me is the magic and like the dragons. I would love more of that, but I don't think this book is really about that, even though they're in the story. Still, I'm only a third of the way in, so we will see what happens next. As well, I started reading Dark One, Brandon Sanderson's graphic novel type thing. Is this the beginning of a series or just a standalone? I don't know yet. Anyway, I'm about halfway through, and in the beginning I felt like it was very dialogue heavy, and I still feel like a lot of the frames in the comic don't really add much to the story. Just it's a lot of dialogue. However, I'm halfway through now and I think I'm really getting the setup and understanding where the different characters kind of fit into the story and how it's really going to be trying to quite obviously turn the tropes of the Chosen One on their head. But it's also kind of based around this concept of stories it's almost like a story about the stories of chosen ones. So I do think the story is interesting. I just don't know that I like the execution of the story in graphic form. I mean the colors in the colors are quite beautiful in the art, but the actual art itself I'm not a fan of. And beyond the actual art, like just the way that it's telling the story through this format, I'm not sure that it's the best. But anyway, I'm gonna try and finish that. I'm gonna take it with me now. I'm going to Jason's place. As well, I'll listen to Fires of Vengeance some more while I drive over there. So hopefully I can make some more progress on things. Hello, so welcome to me a Sunday night being super tired and probably needing to go to bed soon so that I can somehow survive next week. I think I'm probably going to extend this blog because I still haven't even finished Fires of Vengeance. I had plans to read 2 audiobooks this week, but my brain was so full of work. I didn't have the brain power to listen to audiobooks as much as I wanted to. Like, there were times when I could have listened to audiobooks, but I didn't because my brain was exploding with thoughts about work, which is not how I want to use my brain power. Like, work can have 40 hours a week, maybe 50, but the rest of the time I want my brain to myself. So I did read a little bit more of Fires of Vengeance while I was driving around this weekend. I think I'm maybe like halfway through, a little bit past halfway now. And I have remembered what I didn't like about the first book. In the first book, there was all this fighting, but it was just like these people fighting within themselves and kind of like as part of this like tournament thing where they would battle against each other. And there was a lot of just training, like fighting as training. And I didn't care who won because it didn't actually matter. And now again, we're like training to fight. And I just find it really boring. And I just want to get into like the actual issue we're having. Anyway, I will continue to listen to that. As well, I did finish reading Dark One, and I've seen this listed places as a standalone, but based on the ending, I don't think it's gonna be a standalone, or it better not be a standalone. I do feel like there's just too much crammed into this story, and it's really hard to tell that much of an epic story from a graphic kind of perspective. So there were bits at the end where I'm a little bit confused. I'm not confident that my interpretation of what's happened is exactly what's happened. Well, like, I kind of understand the broad strokes of the story, but the details, maybe not entirely. And I just think that like the story that's being told here doesn't necessarily suit graphic form, or if it does, then it needs to be told in quite a different way. I think Brandon Sanderson's got a lot of work to do to write a good graphic novel, to be honest. It's still probably better than lots that are out there. Like, it was an okay reading experience, but being Brandon Sanderson, you know, you go on with high expectations. And still, like, it wasn't an amazing reading experience like some of my favourite graphic novels. So as well, I started reading The Liminal Space. I realised that there's only like 3 more days of the month, so I still have this and 2 other books on my TBR. I don't think I'm going to get through the other 2, but I'm going to try and get through this because it's only like 200 pages and the font is kind of like the spacing is like double line spacing or something. And also, I read the first 2 chapters and they were super short, so I think it'll be a really quick read. All I've done so far really is meet this guy who likes to go to the library and has a lot of books, and apparently the people in the small town where he lives tell a lot of stories about him, but he says that they have really exaggerated the truth. The only thing we really know about him other than that is he used to be a doctor. And then as well, there was a short chapter about this woman basically having to get dinner ready for her husband, and he comes across as quite an asshole already, so hopefully she will get rid of him. So I'll try and finish this and finish off Fires of Vengeance, and I'll tell you about them as I go. I am once again going to the office 4 out of 5 days this week, and I'm not looking forward to it. I also have a new boss starting this week, so hopefully that will go well and everything will get better and I will be much happier. Hopefully. But right now, I'm going to go and have a bath and then go to bed.
Hello, it's Tired Penny back again to talk to you about reading, which I haven't had that much time for over the last couple of days. Work has just been ridiculous lately, but tonight I've gotten home early and I don't really have too much to do except for like a bit of organizing to try and get myself out of this over busy situation. And I'm gonna try and catch up on my reading. It's the last day of the month. There's two things I wanna finish off before the month is over. So firstly, I wanna finish listening to Fires of Vengeance. I think that it's only gonna take me about an hour and a little bit more to finish that audiobook. So it should be doable, and I need to do some housework so I can do both at the same time. I have been enjoying what's been happening more recently because we have actually been using the magic in actual battles and learning a little bit about the history of the world. And I think as well, it's been, instead of just like fighting and vengeance and all that stuff that I don't enjoy so much, it's been getting a little bit into this political conflict and really looking at whether the side that we are on, or the people that we're following are on, are they on the right side? So maybe both sides have done bad things, so where's the balance there? Can you do bad things and still be on the good side? And just now I just started listening to it again, and we're getting a little bit of like the Queen's sister's perspective, and the Queen's sister is kind of trying to fight for the throne, and having heard both their perspectives, you can really see how they both think that they are the one who should be on the throne. I don't know if there's an actual throne. I'm not sure it's that kind of kingdom. Anyway, I'm interested to see what will happen in the last hour as well. I read a little bit more of this beautiful book last night, and a couple of things. So firstly, I thought that this was set in like a small town in New Zealand because it is a New Zealand author, but it actually seems that it's set in a small town out of London, because we got introduced to another character who's one who's been trying to be like a successful businessman in London, but he's not doing too well, and so he's come back to the small town in order to ask his dad for some money. While he's there, there's a car accident involving some of the characters that we've met. So that's what happened just before I fell asleep last night. So I'm interested to see how that's gonna play out as well. So this other character that I kind of think of as the main character, even though it's from all their perspectives, he's like this older guy who used to be a doctor, and he has all these books, and people just kind of turn up and treat it like a library, even though he's kind of said it's not a library. But also he kind of has like synesthesia, where when he sees people, he associates them with a color, and he kind of thinks of this as like his magic, and he tries to use this to help find the book that they need. So like, I can see that maybe that's where the magical realism aspect might come in. I don't know if this book's meant to be magical realism, but for some reason I feel like it should be. So maybe it will be. As well, I'm going to try and read some more of this tonight. I really want to try and finish it. It's only 200 pages, so it's totally doable to finish it tonight. I did find like it's quite a quick read. Last night I didn't read very much, but that was mainly because I was super tired and I only spent like 5 minutes reading it. But in that 5 minutes I did get through quite a lot, so I'm gonna go and see if I can finish things off, and then I will check back in with you. Hello, so quick update before bed, because I really need to go to bed. So I finished listening to Fires of Vengeance, and I think that I liked it more than the first book in the series. I will admit that the first book in the series wasn't my favorite. Like, I liked it, but I wasn't blown away like some people were. I found Tao very boring, and a lot of the fighting just had no real meaning, and so I found it boring. But you know, there were bits in there that showed promise, and so I thought this one would be better, and I think this one focused more on the things that I find interesting. There was still a lot of fighting that didn't really seem to have much purpose, but I did like how this one looked at grief, and also this idea of whether you can still be on the side of good if you do bad things. I didn't really buy the romance at all, but I suppose it was fine. It was kind of predictable. And I mean, some emotional things happened at the end. And again, I will say that what happened at the very ending kind of sets up for something more exciting in the future. Like, maybe the fighting in the future will actually have a purpose, and maybe we'll learn more about this demon world, and maybe something about this goddess that they worship. And I guess we'll learn more about their enemies as well. Their actual enemies, not their internal enemies. I do think that I'm really glad in this case that I listened to this on audiobook, because I think if I'd been reading it physically, I would have struggled to get through it. And in fact, to be honest, there's no way I would have got through that first book if it hadn't been for the audiobook. But anyway, on the other side of things, I have nearly read all of this tonight. I'm like 50-ish pages from the end, and I'm somewhat concerned because our characters are all really struggling emotionally, and things are getting quite intense. But we've only got 50 pages left. How can we possibly wrap things up in 50 pages? Like, I can't see how things are going to be resolved in a way that's going to make me happy. I'm pretty sure that one of the characters is going to die of cancer. Another character is really depressed. Another one's being abused by her husband. The other one, his situation's not that bad, but he's kind of an asshole. Or just has a really wrong perception of things. But at the same time, I just really want them all to be happy. Can we get to happy within 50 pages? I don't know. I'm going to read this a little bit before I go to sleep. And then I think if I fall asleep before I finish it, I'll finish it off tomorrow for sure. So I'm still going to count it as a win for June. And I mean mainly just because I'm really enjoying it. So bonus. Hello. So, I meant to finish this vlog days ago, but I didn't. Next week I really need to focus on being less busy at work and like spending more time on me and just sleeping and exercising and feeling like a healthy human being. But regardless, let's finish this vlog off. So, I did finish reading The Liminal Space. I do think that I would have been better just to read right through to the end in one go. Like, this is almost the perfect book for reading in one sitting. Because I think if you read it that way, you'll just, like, get really engaged with the characters. And I think the ending was a little bit rushed. But if I'd read it all in one go, I probably would have just still been really emotionally impacted, but because I took a little bit of a break, that gave me some space, and then it didn't upset me as much as it could have. It's really just about this man and the influence he has on other people and helping them out. And I guess there's also a strong message about like not worrying about what other people think about you and just living the life that's right for you. Anyway, I do think it's a really beautiful little book. There wasn't any magical realism as I was hoping, but still just a really beautiful little book, and I think the cover suits it really well. I did read actually one review that said that the author had done really well capturing that feeling of a small town in the UK, and I think it's kind of funny because to me I think it felt a lot like a small town in New Zealand as well. Maybe not quite that New Zealand vibe because it's not set in New Zealand, but I suspect that there's not as much of a difference as you might think. Anyway, that means we finished the reading for June. I definitely didn't read as much as I was hoping in June. It was kind of a disaster month, which is the opposite of what I was hoping it was gonna be. I was hoping that it was gonna be a get my shit back together month, but we'll reallocate those hopes and dreams to July. Anyway, thank you so much for hanging out with me over the last week and a half. I don't even know how long it's been. Let me know how you're going with your reading, and if you've read any of the books I talked about on this vlog, I'd love to discuss them more with you down in the comments. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're doing well, and I will see you next time.